Wing F-84. This green war fighter bomber was used primarily for low-level interdiction missions, attacking bridges and enemy railroads with bombs and rockets. In 1956, the team transitioned to the world's first supersonic fighter, the Swept-Wing F-100 Super Sabre. Originally designed for air-to-air combat, it too became a multi-role fighter used extensively in Vietnam to attack targets both in the sky and on the ground. And while the team briefly flew the F-105 Thunder Chief, another Vietnam Air Force returned to the F-100 for a total of 13 years. In 1969, the twin-engine McDonnell Douglas F-4 Phantom II was proudly painted in leather covered. This Vietnam fighter flew air superiority, close air support, long-range strike, and recon missions for the Air Force, Navy, and Marine Corps. In fact, it was the first and only fighter that both the Thunderbirds and the Blue Angels had flown. After flying a total of 518 shows for a record 12 million people, the Thunderbirds transitioned to the supersonic Warbird T-38 Talon in 1974. The T-38 demonstrated to the American public what high-performance aircraft could do, and it did that job impressively and reliably. Frontline Air Force fighter, the F-16. This multi-role fighter was seen by nearly 17 million people in 33 states in its first year. Today, the team flies a Lockheed Martin F-16C Fighting Falcon, commonly referred to as the Viper. It's used around the globe to find and attack targets both in the air and on the ground. Its powerful Pratt & Whitney engine produces more than 29,000 pounds of thrust. That is approximately 85,000 horsepower, more than the entire starting